Oh, by the way, David, I knew there was something I wanted to tell you. Who do you think I bumped into at the club last night?
Who?
Your general manager.
Not old Hood.
None other. Spent quite a pleasant half hour with him.
As we hope you will with A Life of Bliss. Being the biography of a bachelor with Diana Churchill, Colin Gordon, Eleanor Summerfield, Barry K. Barnes, Desmond Carrington, and Percy Edwards. Yet another episode in the life of that shy young man, David Alexander Bliss, known to us as George Cole.
Spent a pleasant half hour with old Hood?
Yeah, at the club.
I can hardly believe it.
Oh, but then he happens to be your boss. You're bound to have a distorted picture.
Well, I suppose so.
Actually, he's quite human.
Good gracious, I didn't know it was that distorted.
We got on pretty well together.
Did he mention me?
Fishing for compliments?
Oh, no, just interested.
Well, I don't know whether he was being tactful because I'm your brother-in-law, but he couldn't have been fairer.
Why? What did he say?
He didn't mention you.
You can't say fairer than that.
Oh, bless your heart. Shall I tell you what he really said?
What?
That you'd made a big success of running the branch office.
Honestly?
Honestly.
Oh, gosh. Wonders will never cease.
He said that, too. That really proves my point, you know. A dry sense of humor and a taste for scotch? What could be more human than that?
Oh, don't worry. I was only joking. He's a jolly nice chap, actually. But you're still right about the distorted picture. I certainly can't visualize him, well,
relaxing over a noggin.
Hardly.
Well, he did.
I'd have said he was rather stiff.
Oh, he didn't have that many.
rather unapproachable, too.
Huh.
And I don't mean that unkindly, of course, but, well, I've never felt I could go to him when I'm in trouble.
Well, it's just as well. The poor man's got to do some work.
No, but seriously.
Seriously, it's never easy when you're in a position of authority.
I still think you can be approachable. Anyway, I think it's better from your own point of view. Well, I know I'd like to feel Jennifer could come to me if she were worried. And I'm sure she would.
Jennifer? Oh, your secretary.
Yes.
As a matter of fact, you know, it can be a disadvantage. I say that from personal experience. A secretary of mine who went through an emotional crisis. Dear, oh, dear, oh, dear, how that girl could cry.
No, what was her name?
Oh, I forget now. It was a good many years ago. Attractive little thing, redhead. Went on for week after week. You'd never known such chaos. Work was practically at a standstill, and the tension was terrific.
Tension?
You never knew when the monsoon was going to break. I couldn't sign a letter without the ink running.
You wouldn't by any chance be exaggerating?
Not by any chance. I've got laundry bills to prove it.
What, for all the extra handkerchiefs?
Handkerchiefs, shirts, pressing my suits.
Pressing your suits?
She liked a shoulder to cry on. Yeah, the whole thing was most disconcerting.
Oh, I can imagine. You know, there's one thing about it. You may not think much of Jennifer as a secretary, but you must admit she's always bright and cheerful.
I admit she's cheerful.
Well, that's better than having someone cry on your shoulder.
I'm sure you're going to be...
Oh, hello, darling.
I'm sure you're going to be late for the office, David.
Oh, I'm not, you know. That clock's fast.
It isn't, you know. I put it right this morning.
Really? Good heavens. Well, I must fly. He'll be furious if I'm not there when he arrives.
Who?
Old Hood said he might... Well, I brought a file back last night.
On the bookcase, I think. Said what?
That he might pop into my office on his way down.
Yes, you can hardly expect him to be approachable at the moment. After all, he's got a problem of his own.
Has he?
Oh, of course, I didn't tell you. You know he's got a son?
Yes, Donald. I've met him once or twice. Why?
He's studying to be an architect, and his father doesn't approve of his plans.
Doesn't approve of
he's
his...
He's planning to get married.
Honestly?
No, that's what Hood suspects, anyway.
But he's not sure?
Pretty sure.
Who's the girl, do you know?
No, and neither does he, not even her name. The whole affair's a deep, dark secret.
Then how does he happen to know about it at all?
Well, would you say it was easy to keep something from him?
What, from old Hood?
Yeah.
Oh, gosh, anything but. He literally reads my mind.
Yes, but that comes under a rather special heading.
Rather special heading?
Space fiction. Only putting a leg up, boy.
But if he doesn't know
who... Poppet, you ought to be going.
Yes, all right, but doesn't know who the girl is, I don't see how he can disapprove.
Well, believe me, he does, violently. Understandably, too. Apparently this, what did you say his name was, the son?
Donald.
Well, apparently Donald's about to take his final exam. He ought to be concentrating on his work, not on marriage.
No, there's something in that, but I wouldn't know the answer. I mean, what can his father do about it?
Nothing, really, especially with it being wrapped in secrecy. It couldn't be more frustrating for him, and you know what that means.
Well, he'll be even more unapproachable than usual. Still, never mind. I know the answer to that.
You do?
Approach him at the double. Cheerio. See you this evening.
Mr. Bliss's secretary, who's calling?
Hello, Jennifer.
Donald, it's you. Where are you phoning from?
A call box near the house. Is it all right to talk?
Yes, David hasn't turned up yet. Hope he's not going to be late. We're expecting his nibs. Expecting your father. Sorry about that. I just can't get used to the idea of... Well, darling Donald.
You know something? I think Father's more or less guessed I want to get married.
Oh, dear, has he?
Afraid so. Not that it matters. I've got to tell him about us sometime.
Yes, and I know what'll happen when you do. Still, at least it'll be original.
Original?
He'll gain a daughter and I'll lose a job.
Nonsense. I'm sure he wouldn't.
I'm sure he would.
You're wrong about Father, you know, but then it's difficult for you to know what he's really like.
Yeah, I suppose so.
Actually, he's quite human.
Golly, I wasn't even close. Sorry, I'm only joking.
Oh, I hate all this secrecy. Not for myself, for you.
Yes, but I think it's for the best, darling, and I don't mind, not a bit. It's a bit of a strain, though. I'm terrified I'll blurt it out to David one of these days.
Well, there's no reason why he shouldn't be let into the secret, is there?
Golly, there is. You know, he'd soon be in trouble.
I'm sure he wouldn't think of saying anything to Father.
No, of course not. That's the trouble. He says things without thinking. He's as bad as I am for that. Well, perhaps that's being unkind. Jolly nearly, though. Besides, it wouldn't be fair to tell him, really. It'd only put him in an awkward position.
You may be right.
I do hope he's not going to be late. His nibs will be furious.
I shouldn't worry about that. His nibs is still in the middle of breakfast.
Is he? Oh, good. Oh, dear, did I say it again? I can't think why you love me.
Just because you're you.
For all stupid reasons.
Do you love me?
For all stupid questions.
I'll never get tired of hearing the answer.
All right, then. Darling Donald,
I... Morning, Jennifer.
I am afraid you've got the wrong number. There you are at last.
Well, not another wrong number.
Yes.
I don't know what's the matter with the exchange just lately. I've never known so many.
Yeah, I know. Practically every time he rings, the phone rings.
I thought perhaps it was old Hood to say he wasn't coming. Oh, well, start of another day. Bring the post into my office.
Righto.
Don't forget to put the phone through.
No, I won't. Very poor hall this morning, only four. One of those is for his nibs. I didn't readdress it because I knew he was coming in. That one, look.
Oh, yes. Hey, guess what? Tony bumped into him last night.
Into his nibs?
At the club. And do you know what he said? That old Hood was quite human.
Good gracious, that's exactly what Donald... Exactly the opposite I should have said.
Well, we're bound to have a distorted picture.
You're bound to.
And Tony's a pretty good judge of character, so there you are. There's probably something in it.
Oh, definitely. They can't both be wrong.
They?
I know somebody else who thinks the same.
Really?
Mm.
Who's that?
Oh, you wouldn't know him, but that's exactly what he said.
What?
That his father was human. His nibs was human. What's the matter with me this morning? Sounding more like you every minute. Sorry, it's just a joke. What on earth was he doing there?
Relaxing over a noggin.
Mr. Hood?
I know. I couldn't visualize that either. Come to think of it, I've never visualized him as having a private life at all. Oh, well, we must get on. Let's see. You can file that.
You're all right.
It's strange, you know, but I don't think we ever do. Not when we work with people. Now, I've been with old Hood for donkey's years now, and yet, as far as I'm concerned, he still remains, well, just a face across a desk.
Yes, I know. Frightening, isn't it?
But behind that face is a man. A man with problems like you and I.
You speak for yourself. Sorry.
You'd better be on your best behavior when he's here. There happens to be a problem behind that face at the moment. It must be quite a headache, too.
Really? What's that?
Well, you know his son, Donald. Hello? David Bliss.
Hood.
Oh, good morning, face.
Oh.
Good morning, sir. I've been expecting you.
I've been delayed. I'll be wanting to take the figures on the Chandler affair. See to it, will you?
Straight away.
Oh, and Dave Bliss.
Sir?
A word of warning. I'm not in the best of moods this morning. I've got a headache.
Yes, so I hear. And jolly worrying, too.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.